Athlete Trainer Lynn here. Sorry if I sound like I'm sick, it's just pollen allergies. But let's talk about Sun and Moon instead. They're getting closer every day, and I'm super hyped about it. We're sure to get some sweet new Pokemon, so we're all extremely excited to see what they'll look like. We know folklore and myths are often used as inspiration for Pokemon designs, and I know a few I think would make interesting Pokemon, so naturally I'll be trying to convince you guys that these would be cool Pokemon by telling you about them, and by showing you the concept drawings I made of them. Let's get started right into number one. So the first Pokemon I want is one based on a fawn. It doesn't necessarily have to look half human, but a goat-like creature walking on two legs would be super cool. It could be an innocent nature-looking creature reflecting the light, happy fairy tale version, kinda like Mr. Tumnus from Narnia. Even though a fawn would make a perfect grass type, we just got the grass goat Go-Go, so I didn't take my design there. The other version could be a dark type or a psychic type, reflecting the darker version of Tails. Because if you've heard old fairy tales, they're not all super happy and nice. So the mystery around them could be represented by the psychic type. I don't think my versions made the concept justice, but I think a fawn Pokemon has the potential to look really cool. The second Pokemon I want is kinda mythical creature. The reason I say it like that is because it comes from a real decaying whale corpse. That sounds really weird, but let me explain. So basically this whale's corpse decays in a way that makes two of its bones look like giant tusks. So people looked at it and they thought it was some kind of big pig creature swimming around in the sea. And that's how it all started. Hence the name Sea Swine. It could be a fish-like Pokemon with a pig face. Or it could walk on land as a water type, but still resemble a boar. Obviously for my version I went for the fish one. I even gave it little feet so it could walk on land. So in that way I kinda went with both versions. But it's adorable, right? Wouldn't you like this in a Pokemon game? I sure would. The third creature I want is a Rat King. If you don't know what a Rat King is, then prepare to get disgusted. How about this? I'll warn you before the picture comes up, okay? So a Rat King is not a cute little rat with a tiny crown and it rules over other rats. It's actually multiple rats, and they're all stuck together by their tails and sap, dirt, or hair, or eyes, or just anything really. And they can't get away, so they die. It's not entirely a mythical creature, it's 100% real. And I have a picture to show you, so 3, 2, 1. Yep, here it is, it's kinda gross, and I did warn you, so you could have looked away, but you didn't, so don't blame me. And now it's gone. So, why do I want this in a Pokemon game? Well, for starters, I heard about Rat Kings when I was 9 or 10 or so, and the concept just stuck with me. Because it's really gross, and I just can't forget about it now. When you think about it, there are many ways it could be turned into a cool Pokemon. It could be a royal-looking rat, or some kind of multi-limbed mutation, like several eyes or several tails or something. We already have a Pokemon like that, so I mean, it would fit right in. Dodrio's got two heads, Dodrio's got three heads, so it's not that weird. It could be a normal type because it's a rodent, or maybe a grass type, or a dark type because for obvious reason, Rat Kings were associated with bad omens and bad things in general. Or a ghost type, because they're dead. Okay, I'll stop talking about dead rats now, let's just move on. The next one I would call Huldra or Skogsrå. It's a beautiful female nature spirit with an empty hollow tree back. And she lures in people with her beauty, and if you look at her hollow back it will steal your soul away or something like it. Kinda like Shedinia's back. My concept design isn't very human looking, and it's not that beautiful, it's more a cute Pokemon. It kinda just looks like a nature spirit. And the back is sort of hollow, or it could have a pattern, I haven't really decided. Either way, its back should have some kind of meaning to it. Maybe it could suck out people's energy, or it could be used to hypnotize foes with some weird pattern. I don't know. There are many ways it could be turned into a cool Pokemon. So the last creature for today is the chimney creature. So it's a creature that climbs down chimneys. No, not you, Santa, go away. I'm talking about a more malicious creature, more like a prankster or evil kind of Pokemon. A dark type would fit it perfectly, or maybe even a rock type or fire type just to tie in the chimney thing. I just really like the idea, I'm not sure why, I mean, it's kinda creepy and I keep looking at our open fireplace. expecting something to come out any moment. Maybe I shouldn't have put it on the list, I'm creeping myself out. You know what, let's just finish up the video. So these are the 5 mythical creatures I think would make awesome Pokemon. But these are merely concepts, I basically drew the first thing that came to mind so I could illustrate the idea. If you'd like to draw a design based on these concepts, I would really love to see it, so please tweet at me on Twitter. Or if you know any cool mythical creatures you'd like to see as Pokemon, you can tell me in the comments below. Thank you all for watching!